Hi, I'm Kathy Thomas, and joining me today will be the co-founder of Wahoo's Fish Tacos, a success story that now boasts more than 60 eateries. Wing Lam grew up in a restaurant family and established the first Wahoo's Fish Tacos in 1988 with his two brothers. And at the heart of his success is his generous nature, his winning personality, and of course, those fish tacos. Welcome, Wing. I'm so glad you're here.
Glad to be here.
So I want to know about your famous fish tacos.
Well, you know, back in the college days, San Diego State, you spend a lot of time, you know, when you're not in classes, going down surfing south of the border. And basically, what you eat when you're down there surfing is fish tacos. Yeah, so I just twisted it a little bit because they deep fry them down there. Mm-hmm. I wanted mine to be a little healthier. And we also brought in a little bit of Asian or Brazilian influence. So I got some of my dad's sauces here, some of the Mexican hot sauces. This is fresh Wahoo that I just brought. It's been marinating for a couple of hours here. And you can see these are beautiful fillets that we're gonna throw out on the grill.
Let's go out to the grill.
You got it.
A little oil on a paper towel so that the fish won't stick.
Oh, look at that.
Ah, perfect. About how long is this gonna take?
I'll take a couple of minutes per side. The only thing you wanna watch for, the edges will start getting white, and then you just flip it over just one time.
Oh yeah, I can already see it right here.
Perfect. Look at that, it's ready to go.
Perfect. Corn tortillas, flame.
We got it.
And you could have done this right on the grill.
Yes, I could have done it, but we're indoors. It's a little warmer in here.
Yeah, it's
perfect.
Cozy.
All we do is we get some of the pieces of the fish. You can tell right here.
All right.
We have some jack and cheddar cheese right here. So just a little sprinkle right there. This is a little something from my dad's restaurant. This is actually an Asian-inspired hot sauce, and it has a whole different taste profile to it.
Mm-hmm.
We get a little bit of the cabbage to add a little crunchiness to it. We also have a little fresh, spicy green hot sauce. A little bit of lime right there. You can taste it fresh when it's at the very end.
It's really important.
Yes. And then at the end, we'll put a little bit of the fresh pico de gallo right on top. Seasoned white rice. And then we got the black beans. And you gotta always have a couple of chips just for
luck. Crunch.
And there you are.
I think I'm in love. Thank you so much, Wing. This has been so much fun, and I'm looking forward to eating these tacos.
Yes, they're going to be very good.
I know they are. Here's a quick tip from Melissa's. Fingerling potatoes, they're such interesting shapes and delicious flavors, but how in the heck do you cook them? And if you just roast them, they get kind of crusty and dry. So I found the best way to do it is to simply cut them in half lengthwise, like so, put them in a baking dish. Then go ahead and add a quarter cup of dry white wine, a quarter cup of high quality olive oil, and some fresh thyme leaves, and give it a stir. Sprinkle on a little kosher salt, and cover them tightly with aluminum foil. Now it goes into a 375 degree oven. Cover it up tight for about 10 to 15 minutes. And then you take the foil off and let them go another 20 to 30 minutes. Out of the oven now, and they just look gorgeous. They're nice and soft on the inside and crispy on the outside. And they can be done ahead, and they're even good cold as an appetizer with dips. A little bit of fresh thyme on the top. Fingerling potatoes, they're delicious. The fruit and vegetable aisles are filled with so much potential. Try something new. Have an adventure.